We are here in the garage with the heater on because winter is coming soon and the car will be going away for the winter to hibernate. Yes. Those are summer tires. They will not be going on the roads. All right. Thing is, we've had this car now 5 years, but it's 10 years on the road. Yes. And what do you think for a car with 10 years on the road? Everybody says Mercedes isn't reliable, yes, right? And what do you think?
This car's been really reliable for us. We haven't had any issues with it.
Right.
No major repairs, just, you know, the usual oil change. But that's it. And we've had the car 5 years now. Honestly, it's like a brand new car. When you get into it, it looks and it feels like it's still brand new. It even has that new car smell, which I love.
We call that leather cleaner because really that's a lot of what it is, but that's part of maintenance,
yeah,
right? Like
exactly.
The thing is, if you don't take care of your car, it'll end up like junk or, you know, and if it starts off with junk, it won't help, but
yeah.
The car's been good. What I noticed is the paint job. It's got a little bit of road dirt on it now, right?
Yeah.
But what I noticed was when I polished it up, the paint job looks...
Yeah.
The same as it did when I saw it 5 years ago and it rolled up.
Yeah.
So,
it's been really good. It's a fun car to drive. It's, like we've said before, it's a cool mom car for sure.
Right.
Yeah.
But is it an affordable mom car? Like, gas is expensive in this car. Do you sometimes wish we had a cheaper car?
You drove all the time, then
right,
perhaps, but because we're not driving it every day, it's okay, I think.
It's not a weekend car because it is a daily driver when I'm not working from home.
Yeah.
But if you had a long commute, you'd be looking at huge gas bills.
Yeah. Which you
certainly
used to
tire bills, but yeah, there's that too.
Yeah. But all in all, it's been a good car, and I would say this particular year is really good, and you can probably get it now for
a lot less than what we paid.
Yeah, probably like
20 to 25,000 maybe.
Yeah,
right. And that's a lot of horsepower. It's 481 is what they say.
Mm-hmm.
You've enjoyed the horsepower.
I have, yes. If you watch our previous video, yeah, it just gets up and goes, and you don't even realize how fast you're going. That's how quick it gets up to speed, and yeah, you have to watch out. You have to be looking actually down at the speedometer.
Like, so far, really, it's just been oil changes and then, tires and winter tires when I drove it in winter.
Yeah.
However, is that going to be the same for the next 5 years? Right now, it has just 30,000 miles, 50,000 kilometers on it.
Yeah.
So maybe that's part of the magic, is just not having a lot of
mm-hmm.
miles on it, but mm-hmm. also maintenance and doing everything that needs to be done when it needs to be done.
Mm-hmm.
And the sunroof is open, not because it won't close, just because I left it open. Because it was actually warm enough today in the sun to have it off.
Yes, earlier. Not
now. Not now, no. Which explains why we have the heater in the garage.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah.
Coolest thing about the car for you, would it be the red brake calipers?
I don't really get into that. I don't know that so much. I would say I like the way it looks. It's sleek and sporty. It's classic sporty, I guess. And I like that it's a four-door, so the kids can somewhat fit in the back.
Although we had to move the seat up today for the three-year-old, right?
She's really long legs, so
yes,
I had to move them up for her. But I like the way it feels inside. I can show you actually.
Yeah.
Let's take a look.
All right, go on in.
Yeah, so it's just nice leather interior. I love the wood in here.
Which is still, the leather's still good. Like, part of the feeling people complain about is like the leather not doing well, but it actually has done pretty well here.
It's been really good, and the seats are really formed to hug your body, because it is more of a racing mm-hmm. type feel. So yeah, you feel really safe and tucked in here, which is nice.
And you can see the wear if you on the steering wheel where I grab it. Right in the Alcantara right there.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I guess I got it in the shadow there. I don't have it there now. But other than that, we're not seeing... There's a lot of plastics because it is a C-Class, but it still ends up being better plastics than a lot of them. Mm-hmm. And Lord knows we've had our share of junk cars.
Yes, we have.
Let's take it on the road, see what happens. All right, I'm going to show you something right here. Two things that drive me crazy. One is this... Check the light. It doesn't matter. I don't fix it because every time I fix one light, another light breaks. So I just hit this button here and boom. Oh, is it two now? Do I have two messages? Here, let's see. Oh, two messages. See, when I started the car this morning, it had just one. I love the way this looks, but man, oh man. You can't Bluetooth audio through it. Oh, so here's what I've had to do. That's an old iTouch from easily more than 10 years ago, but I bought a Bluetooth device off Amazon and it was crap, wasn't it, Amy? Just cut out?
Always cut out.
Yeah. So that's a pain in the butt. But I do like this feature that's so James Bondish, and it goes down. I don't like the ones where they just sit up there.
All the time.
Yes, I think that's just ugly. We're out of the car wash and into the great darkness of the north. But after 5 years, Aim, you've enjoyed it, I bet. Am I a scary driver?
At times, when you're not expecting it, yes. But
it's easy to be a scary driver with this, right?
It is, yeah, it's easy. It doesn't take much. I was a scary driver a couple weeks ago driving this car.
Yes, we saw. Mm-hmm. Here, let's switch it around. I'm gonna have Amy drive for a bit. Let's, here, clap. All right, I think the first thing is, do we need the heat on?
Yes, we need the heat on. The heat, the seat
You've already
warmer,
got the seat here, okay.
That is on.
All right, do you know how to turn it on?
The heater?
Yeah.
Well, I don't drive this car very often, but I'm assuming.
Yeah. Oh, there you go. We are not. This is mono. We are taking off mono.
And off
and
the
I
AC.
Am putting it on. Let me put, the AC is, keeps it warm. Here, you hit auto, right? There. Now mine is on, is cool. All right. That's one good thing is you've got separate climate controls.
Yes.
All right. This is our first car with separate climate controls. So here's one thing that bothered me. Look at this. This kind of ring around the cup holder. That.
I never noticed that.
Yeah, I know. But you know what? When you're in a car a lot, you notice it. But like seriously, mm-hmm. It's the only thing I've seen that's flawed. This still works. This is, pardon me. Yeah. Everybody's biggest fear, right? That doesn't work. Do you remember how to put it in super secret sport mode? All right, here's a hint. You're gonna press this button here. It says sport.
Ah.
All right, now this button right here. Press it once. It's in sport. Press it again. It's in manual once we're out of reverse. Ah. Now it's all up to you. And it's still too hot in here. You're probably going to want it also to do the sunroof, right?
It's this warm. You can keep the roof.
I know you better than that as soon as we go. All right, see it closed. All right, let's do it.
Not going to do what I did last time.
Uh-huh. What did you do last time? What? I don't recall what you did last time. Oh, yes.
A little too much fun.
Are you using the paddles?
Yeah.
There
just
you
getting,
go.
Just kidding.
Okay, you went
60.
Yes, you might want to change. Do you remember driving with a manual? Right, you worry about the tachometer, right?
Change it again?
No, that's good. 2.5 is good, although if you're below 2, that's actually like you're cruising RPMs. Because yes, we drive this in winter. I was a daily driver. It was crazy, right?
Yeah.
I can't imagine you driving this in winter, since it seems to be a little crazy. But it was pretty good. All right. The other way to shift is down here. I'll do this. See right now, it's in 3. I'll do this. And there you go. Now it's in 4. Yeah. If you push to the right, it goes up. If you push to the left, it goes down.
Too many options?
Oh no, I would hate that. All right, too many options.
Yeah, it rides really well. You can feel all the bumps in the road because it is a sporty car.
Right, which is one thing we I don't know, I sometimes complain about it, because even though we don't have, like, well, I guess they're good tires and everything, we have the 19-inch stock from AMG, the 19-inch wheels.
Yeah,
you feel every bump on the road.
Definitely. So, yes, everything works. This still works, which is nice. But here, take a look at this navigation system. And I'm finally getting used to it, but it's so old that the city has developed around it, and you don't have everything that you need out of it. Oh, there goes Mom. I shifted for her, and you're in the middle of the lane. You're going to pick a lane?
Oh, yeah.
Pick a lane or a gear?
So there's that, again, in the stereo system, you can't Bluetooth it. You can Bluetooth like your phone, but only for calls, not for stereo, and that's a pain. You can also do CDs, which, yeah, at least it doesn't have a cassette player. That's all I can say. Everything else has been good. I mean, room in the back is good. I can't see anything, so never mind that. But for 10 years... it's great. There was one complaint somebody put on YouTube that, well, geez, it only has, like, at the time, 29,000 miles. I'm like, yeah, it's true, but there's mechanical issues that show up because of mileage, and then there's mechanical issues that show up because of time. And 10 years is when things, you know, that's a long time from the factory, right? It actually was in September of 2010 that the car hit the road for the first time. So, yeah, no, it's only been driven basically one tank of gas per month since it was new. Although I've driven it for 26,000 miles about 38,000 kilometers. And that's been good. Knock on whatever kind of plastic this is. That's it. Another part is this is definitely no S class. There's some hard plastics here that wear well, but are not exactly high end. But I would buy it again because of the fun. And if people are looking for a vehicle that is cost effective, considering how much you get for horsepower,
moms would dig it. All moms.
All right, the good times are many. Have a good one. Remember, subscribe, hit the like button. What is that? What everybody says?
Like.
Oh, right. Like. Look at that. Ah, very nice. All right, so if you're in the market for a W204, definitely a good deal. Make sure you get one that's either had the head bolts done or post head bolts. And check out the owner. I checked out the previous owner because he was a grandpa. And man, he had not really done too much with the car except treat it nicely. So I knew that it was decent. And that makes a big difference when it comes to maintenance, we all know. Take care. See you down the road.